So in the Sharia, in the Islamic ruling, the highest in authority, there are four categories. The highest in authority is the Quran, is Allah's word. If you want to find something, if it's not there in the Quran, you go to the next source. That is the Hadith, the Sahih Hadith, the sayings of the Prophet. In the sayings of the Prophet, the commandment of the Prophet, the call, carries more weight than the actions of the Prophet. So if the commandment and the actions contradict, the commandment carries weight. The third source is the Sahabas, Ijma, the three generations. Sahabas, Tain and Tabitain. The Ijma of these people, of the Sahaba, carries more weight than the individual opinion of the Sahaba. Then Tain, Tabitain. And the last source is the Qiyas. If you don't find in any top three sources, in the Quran, in the Hadith, in the lifestyle of the Sahaba, the Tain and the Tabitain, then you can use Qiyas, analogy, deduction. So Sharia on four things broadly: the Quran, the Hadith. No Sahih Hadith will contradict the Quran. Quran number one. Then comes Sahih Hadith. In the Sahih Hadith, call carries more weight than the Amal. The commandment carries more weight than the action. Then the lifestyle of the three generations, Sahabas, Tain, Tabitain, Ijma carries more weight than individual opinion. Then comes the Qiyas. So this is how we should follow. We should follow Quran and the Sunnah. But now all the groups say we follow Quran and Sunnah, Quran and Sunnah. Everyone, no one says he does not follow Quran and Sunnah. So how should the Quran and Sunnah be followed? The way the Prophet and the Sahabas understood. The way the three generations, the Sahaba said, Allah the Rasul said, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the best generation is my generation. Then the next, then the next. So if there is difference of opinion in how to understand a verse of the Quran, you have to see how did the Sahabas understand it. If you don't find in that, then the next generation, Tabayin. If you don't find in that, then the next generation, Tabe Tabayin. This is how you follow. Because many verses of the Quran, for example, the word Masah has got two meanings: sexual touch, physical touch. When you go to the Hadith, you come to know it is sexual touch, not physical touch. Easy. Similarly, when there is any difference of opinion in understanding any verse of the Quran, you have to understand according. If there are any other verses, commentary of the Quran, Quran is the best. If not, go to the Sahih Hadith of the Prophet. If you don't find there, in the lifestyle of the Sahabas, the Tabayin, the Tabi Tabayin. Finish. So for proof, for Hujjah in understanding the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, you have to follow it according to Allah, His Rasul, and the Salafi Salihin.